Hello and welcome to Angler's Mail TV. This week on the cover is something that every angler should own in my opinion, and I'm going to give you a little demonstration on how to get the most out of your free gift, these three handy disgorgers. So let's have a look at what you get on the front of this week's Angler's Mail. Well, at first glance it looks like you've just got one big disgorger, but actually with this little handy container secured in these little latches here, just pop them out and it gives you three disgorgers, three in one. Now let's go through each single one in turn. Well, what's the first one about? Well, apart from it being a big enlarged disgorger, it's actually very handy, and it's the container that keeps the other three in. If you've ever found yourself in the situation where you've hooked a pike fishing on the river, or you're using big single hooks, this one really does do the job. It's enlarged, but at the end is perfect for just locating the single hook and sliding down. Absolutely brilliant for those big fish situations. So the next one of your free gifts, and this one's my favourite to be honest with you, is it's a two-in-one really. It's the one that you're most likely to use in any situation, and it's red, and I'm going to pinch this one after the show. What it is, it's a standard disgorger at the end. There's your standard size. It's actually bigger than the one I'm going to show you later on. It's used for size, say, 16 to even up to size 8. Perfect for absolutely anything on the river. The next side is your slammo disgorger. Now this is one that I really use all the time. Very simple to use, a modern design, slips on the line, perfect for any tricky hook holes that you've got in any fish. This is the one I'll be using most of the time, definitely. Last but not least is the standard disgorger. Many of you are going to be familiar with one of these. It's your standard head disgorger, used for 99% of disgorging applications. And also, it's got a handy little hole in through the end, so you can put a piece of line through, a little bit of a lanyard, tie it around your neck, never lose it, or if you're like me, it goes straight in the ear. Well, my float's just dipped under, and we're in. This is the reason why we come. I'm using pretty light elastic today. It's a 5/8 MAP. It's absolutely perfect for anything. And as these are new fish, a small fish, they haven't been caught a lot of times. Everything's pretty soft on the mouths. And I don't want to bully them. There's no reason to bully them. Got plenty of time. It's a lovely day. And this seems to handle all the lunges. I'm only using a relatively small hook. Very sharp. I've changed it already three or four times today when pellet fishing, and hopefully I'll get a chance in a second to show you how to use this week's free gift. Live telly doesn't want to come in, but I think it's pretty important to absorb all these lunges. You don't want to go using anything too heavy with new fish. Just take your time with every single fish you land. There's no rush, there's no race. This thing can handle everything. As you'll see, my elastic's pretty much out the length of my pole now, which is important as well for netting them. The last thing you want when using heavy elastic is only a short piece to come out, and you have to fiddle about trying to reach to net them. Everything you'll see is just working in tandems. Really, really nice now. Soft elastic, don't have to bully them. I can use the puller bung if I want to. It's only a small fish. And hopefully, it's really hard fighting. That's one thing I've noticed about these fish here at fishery. Really, really hard fighters. The commons go ballistic, especially when you hook them shallow. And it is the summer, of course. They're at their most active. And there he is. Oh, no. He's not coming in this one. Typical. As I say, there's no rush. There you go. Slipped under the net. And to save me looking around everywhere for my disgorger, where have I put it, you saw earlier, she'll be somewhere here behind my here. And it's just a case of passing it down, putting it over the hook. Out she pops, beautiful fish, and just pop her back. I managed to catch another one. Just alternating between lines now. I'm catching one off one, feeding it, then resting it, then going to my other. And it seems to be a recipe for success. They're queuing up at the moment. Plenty of them, still hard fighting, everything's balanced. Great fishing this. There he goes. And now hopefully I'm gonna get the chance to show you the second disgorger, my favorite, the slammo type. So very simply, nice and easy, this is what you do with a slammo. You'll see it's got the little gauge in there. Pull it through, run it down the line, and it's as simple as that. Out in a second and drop the fish back. So there you have it. Three wonderful disgorgers and absolutely essential.